big moment in the career of JoJo's. So it's a big deal, it's a big fight, but for you it's just part of the journey. You enjoy being a part.
Yeah, I'm enjoying it, yeah. It's not bad, you get to punch people in the face for a living.
And you get to live in California, an exotic location, have a big bet. How is that there at altitude?
Yeah, it's cool. It's in a, you know, we stay in a cabin, like one of the log cabins in the mountains, and you know, it's fresh air, it smells like Christmas, like pine, and we're down to business there, under Eagle Sanchez, you know, took quite a tough regime in training, especially at altitude, so it's very tough.
Where do you see yourself in a year, Joe? Where would you like to be in a year? How many more fights and at what level?
I want to keep on, like, we've got a list of names of opponents.
Well, just tell me then.
Like the next year I want to be in bigger and bigger fights, and you know, I want to win a world title by 2020.
In that mix?
Yeah, I want to be right up in the top there. I think the three that are, you know, the really tough ones at the top there, the Joshua, the Wilder, and the Fury. So I think all the rest, I want to juggle all through.
Very engaging man, and actually sickeningly talented way from boxing. I mean, he's good at everything he's ever tried before. But Richie, you've worked with him, along with Anthony Joshua, in that heavyweight factory in Sheffield, Team GB, that wonderful amateur system now. And what is your assessment of the amateur Joyce and the professional?
I think, as an amateur, he was one of the fittest guys to come through Sheffield. As a heavyweight, he has got a tremendous work rate, and in World Series boxing, this is amateur. Over 5 rounds, he had 16 contests and only won 14 in 2, and he gave great Alexander Usyk a tremendous fight in your corner. He's defeated tremendous.